Hello friends, so welcome to a new session on mathematics, and in this the following series of sessions we are going to deal with exponents of real number. What exactly are exponents and why are they required? Everything we'll be discussing. So this particular session and the series of the sessions which are going to follow would be very, very important for you to develop good mathematical foundation, because going further, exponents and indices will be used a lot many times in multiple areas of mathematics. Now to begin with, let us consider these two data points. Now it's given that speed of light, you know light, and you must be aware that light travels at a speed of this much, right? So the number is so big that, you know, even to count the zeros will be, you know, a little difficult. So if you see how many zeros following three, it's around 300000000, so around 300 million meters per second, right? 300 million, isn't it? So yes, so basically it is 3 lakh kilometers per second, or it is 300 million meters per second. Okay, now similarly, radius of the earth is 6400 kilometers, which is equivalent to 640000000 meters. Okay, now if you are, let's say if you are doing a calculation related to speed of light in physics, and every time you are to mention the value, it will be too cumbersome to write 3 followed by 8 zeros. Instead of that, if you closely observe, 3 followed by 8 zeros can be written as 3 into 1 followed by 8 zeros, isn't it? This is how you can write, right? 3 followed by 3 into 1 followed by 8 zeros. Now here, this particular value, 1 followed by 8 zeros, can be shorthand written as 10 to the power of 8, yeah, 10 to the power 8, which is nothing but 10 multiplied by 10, how many times? 8 times. So if you see, isn't it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if you see, there are 8 times 10 is being multiplied. So whenever such mathematical calculations are happening, we have a new notation, and which is written as 10. And there is a superscript over it, which is here in this case, it's 8, which means 10 when multiplied by itself 8 times can be written in shorthand like this, right? This is a new notation. Similarly, let us say if I had to write radius of the earth, so radius of the earth is 64, or 6.4 if you are aware of decimal operation, it is 1 followed by 6 zeros. So if you see, this is nothing but 1 million. And 1 million can be written as 10 into 10 into 10. How many times? 6 times, isn't it? So we take advantage of this repetition, and we have now coined a new notation where we write 10 and superscript as 6. So this becomes 10, and we read it as 10 raised to power 6. This is how we, 10 raised to power 6. This is how we define indices. Now, so what is it? So any number, let us say 2, when multiplied 5 times, so 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, this is 2 multiplied by 5 times can be written as 2 raised to the power 5. Now here, 2 is called the base. What is it called? The base. And 5 has multiple names. 1, it can be called as exponent. It can also be called as index, whose plural is indices. And third is power. So you can call it by any name, isn't it? Now, 2 and the base and the exponent, the base and exponent can be any real numbers, can be any real numbers, except in few cases where negative bases are not allowed. except in a few cases where negative bases are not allowed. Also, there are a few cases where also 0 in few cases as base, 0 as base is not allowed. Not allowed. And especially the case of 0 to the power 0. We'll see this is not allowed in mathematics. So, you hope you understood. So, now generalizing, I can say a to the power b. So, this type of number, whenever you encounter. So, what is a here? A is the base and b is the index or the exponent. Okay. So, now in the next session, we will be dealing with laws related to bases and exponents.